Subhanallah, it is cold. It is cold. I just want to put these glasses back. I hold my hair back. And let's go. So, yeah. One thing that I didn't raise in yesterday's video was the fact that last Jumma, someone requested one of our, let's just put it, one of our many spies requested that we send into the masjid to do head counts of how many people they have in there on a Fridays and just generally. Yeah, it's just interesting, isn't it? They say they've got the majority of Wembley with them, you know, majority of the Muslims in Wembley Central, should I say. But we know that that's all a joke, okay? Anyway, one of the committee members, I can't remember which one, I don't even want to mention them by their names now, such despicable individuals. One of the committee members stated that never in the history ever. Why do they have to defraud the election if they had this many people? They stated that they have got over 1,400 applications to deal with. They have over 1,400 applications to deal with.
They're waffling, bruv.
Confirm or deny this committee. Confirm or deny this. 1,400 applications. It's like, wow, man. That's unheard of. So why were you running around knocking up false applications to win the election last time round when you came to power initially? 300 or so, wasn't it? And you discounted 170 of our applications that were legitimate, even though we were going to win. Even if they discounted the application, we were still going to win. But yeah, 1,400 applications, and they're very, very busy doing the admin. They've got the likes of the General Secretary, Chief Project Manager. Yeah, General Secretary rushing through those applications, indeed, rushing them through. But yeah, I found that like highly hilarious. You know, dumb and dumber, as they say, man. My God, 1,400 applications. Wow. Wow. I mean, like, and the fact that you only have 12 to 13 people. Come on, man, justify the numbers. Justify the numbers. We challenge you to justify the numbers, committee. We challenge you. You don't. You just sit there on your tod. I mean, you know, when I used to tell the police this, and we used to come down like, we've met with them, we know, over 27 times, because you called them out 27 times,
yeah,
and that's when they came out. Other than that, we used to speak to them, we used to allow us to speak to them. When you were calling 999, they used to hear us in the background, we used to speak to them for that, and they knew that it was some sort of joke, wasting our police time all the time. Anyway, so 1,400 applications, even the cops used to laugh at you. And they got disgusted the way you guys even came to power. I'm not going to mention the coppers in by name, but they're lovely chaps. They used to wonder, like, you've made a debacle of democracy. One person, one vote. It didn't mean anything. And who are you to disregard the votes?
Yeah.
The 179 votes that people paid, you know, money. Did they even get refunds? They paid money. Who are you to disregard the votes? 170, 180 plus votes. And then you brought in your 350. Oh, we found a ballot box. 2 minutes before the ballot closes. Look what we found. Oh, we found a ballot box. Really, man? Wow, man. That's an embarrassment, man. You talk about a committee. You talk about a committee, and this is what you'd go and do.
With Hanwell, they've raised, what, 8 million?
8 million pounds, mashallah. Subhanallah.
Hanwell
Masjid. Wow, subhanallah. What a beautiful masjid, man. Yeah, they've raised a lot of money.
I think Wembley Central can hold more. Think about it. It can.
It
definitely
can
hold more.
Hanwell Masjid has got many floors, and it's got like a gym, a sister center. We should be ashamed of ourselves. What we could have done and what we did end up achieving. You know, two separate things. Under the auspices, under the reign of this committee, under the reign of the current chairman, and under the reign of the, who's that?
General What's
that?
Secretary.
Yeah, whatever it is. Yeah, yeah. You know, I mean, what we could have achieved, you know, what we never achieved. You know, you've done a few cosmetic changes. Really and truly, it's an absolute joke. A couple of cosmetic changes here and there. And to what avail? To what avail? Huh? Really? Come on. And, but yeah. So yeah, 1,400. This is what the video is going to be called. The fallacy of the 1,400 members. The fallacy of the 1,400 members. Assalamu alaikum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And let me check this out. I'm up in my hat. My head's freezing. Oh, the hat is damp and it's cold. Have you ever put a hat on and it's been damp and it's cold? Oh, I've had that today.
Oh,
you're right there, yeah? You're not gonna give me You know, we don't want to be spreading, you know, stuff. I'm not going to mention what, but you know, it is cold, it is cold. Even his hat is cold. He's been in another car that's been damp all day. Put these face masks up, my friend. Pick these face masks up. I don't know, this is a new one. New face masks. I don't know why I showed you them. But alhamdulillah, yeah, just met with a couple of brothers tonight. You know, just saying that, look, the issue of the masjid hasn't died. It hasn't died. And, you know, it's still ongoing. It's still ongoing.
Yeah, we're not going.
It hasn't died.
Yeah, we're not protesting, but...
Anyway, so the brothers are saying that they missed the videos that used to take place when I was obviously on my bike and outside, you know, doing those analytical videos, you know, a bit circumspect, you know, with regards to what the committee had done and just going through their misdemeanors and their maladministration of the whole affair, the masjid, the way they dealt with the Muslims of the local area, including myself and many other brothers. Court cases still pending, you know, flimsy allegations. Guilty until proven otherwise, or is it innocent until proven guilty? You know, you have to really question, like, you know, what are these guys like? What is this committee like? You know, didn't you have any shame when you sat there and the afternoon you drafted up the false allegations? Yeah. I can imagine the general secretary. Yeah. Write this. He done this too. Yeah. And he done this too.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, I remember. Can you imagine the likes of Naveed and the likes of Arif and the likes of Bashir and Shabir and, you know, all gathering together. He done this. I know he done this. I got you. I know. I have done this too. What? No. Oh my God. Look on your phones. Okay, who got the video? Send me the video on WhatsApp. Quickly. So this is how you guys worked.
That's their full process.
You know, did you not edit the videos like I do? I don't know. What do you not use for editing? Adobe Premiere or DaVinci Pro Resolve? What do you not use? Tell me. I'll be really, really interested.
With the phones.
Yeah. Anyway, so, you know, conjuring. So in the afternoon, you put the evidence together, drafted up the allegations, emailed it off to, you know, the police. And in the evening, you went to pray. How did that prayer feel? My question to all you committee members, you know, who were involved in the culmination of these fake allegations, how did that prayer, when you prostrated in Wembley Masjid that evening, that night, how did you lot feel? Did you feel that you had done some fantastic work? You had strived in the path of Allah. You had strived in the path of the deen. You had earned your sadqa jariya by what? Spreading false allegations, telling lies, to cause trouble and strife to innocent.
I wonder if they go to sleep thinking that they're good people. How they go to sleep thinking that they've done something good in their life. What the hell?
Why? Someone move that. Look, they know the masjid is coming back sooner or later, yeah?
To us.
They know the masjid is coming back. I mean, the weather permitting, I mean, I like, wish I was still cycling. But it's good I got my son to bounce ideas off. You know, but no, what I'm saying is, how do you sleep at night with a clean conscience?
Yes.
Even the coppers are wondering what they reported your son to social. I go, yeah, I got the call while I was on a driving lesson, no less. Hello. Anyway, you know, yeah, I got the call while I was on a driving lesson, and you know, wow, man, you thought we got you arrested. We got you to spend one night down in Charing Cross Police Station. No, you only galvanized us and made us more focused, and our minds were more concentrated on getting you guys out. Hence, we increased the intensity even after COVID of the protests. To let you know that the real Wembley Muslim community, bang, had not gone away.
Yeah.
And then on top of that, you know, when I was obviously told not to go anywhere near the masjid, within 500 meters of the masjid, my son was going down, and he's like, oh, you know what? Let's kick him while he's down. Let's get this dog while he's down. Let's get him while he's down. Let's get him while he's down. What are you going to do? You call Brent Children's Services. Brent Children's Services. Wow, man. Anonymous call. How brave are you guys, man? Look at this. Who's that? Who's that? Who's that gangster at the heart of Mustard? Anyway, Brent Children's Services. You called Brent Children's Services and thought, you know, kick him while he's down. Really? Really? You know, did I become apprehensive? I may become apprehensive, but no. You know, it galvanized me. And my son just laughed it off. He goes, really? Oh, you got reported? I got reported. I go, yeah, they reported you, man. Like, you know.
If you're gonna do something that bad, then.
Do you know what? They are just weak, feeble-minded individuals. That's what they are. Feeble-minded individuals.
It's just stupid. I swear, it's stupid.
There is nothing about them that would want to, you know, lead you or inspire you. You know when you get those time-wasting managers when you work in an office, or time wasters that you get, those time wasters that you get that work in an office, a pain in the backside. Pain in the backside, you know, and that's what these guys are. You know, they don't inspire any confidence. They're there just for the title. Yes, chairman. Yes, head of service. Yes, director of so on and so on and so forth. Whoop, yeah, whoop, 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 whoop. You guys are heroes in your own lunchtime. Heroes in your own little lunchtime, you know. Anyway, alhamdulillah, look, you know, it is what it is, and we are still going to put out these videos.
We have a couple of weeks till the next court case.
Yeah, they want to go and plead the court case all over again to the judge.
Judge ain't gonna like that.
All over again to the judge, and you really, really think?
Wait, doesn't that cost money? Aren't they going to waste their money then?
You know what makes me laugh? Yeah, is that you are going to go to the same judge and tell him, mate, you made a mistake. Your decision-making process was absolutely, it was a full-on debacle. Reassess our case, so on and so forth. You're gonna tell, look, I'll tell you what, you know.
All right, back to the point, yeah?
Yeah, what's that? Sorry.
You were saying the judge
ain't
gonna like that.
Yeah, he's not gonna like, look, it's like, when you get your papers remarked, yeah? Say you got like a dodgy GCSE result, you got a D instead of a C, and then you can have it remarked. And truly, in their heart of hearts, teachers don't really like being questioned. They don't like being questioned, honestly, really.
Oh, well, it depends on the marker. If they feel that they've done it properly, the teachers actually think that.
Well, look at you've had a comprehensive decision. It was a massive 60-page, 80-page. A conclusion in the whole case. I mean, you're asking someone to do something unprecedented, man. You're asking someone to, you're asking someone to basically ban 16 people. He has been given a task that has come along maybe once in 100 years. To ban 16 people that have been going to that masjid for over 30 years, for three generations, and you want to get them banned. And you thought that you could turn this place into a nightclub, boogie on down with your brothers in the nightclub, shut down the masjid, boogie on down. What'd you do there? What'd you do there with like six or seven of you guys? Seriously, what do you guys do there? There's kebabish nights. Maybe you like have tea and baklava nights, copy us lot. You know, because you ain't got your own material, you're not really original. So you have tea and baklava, and who pays for that? Or does everyone bring their own and just scoff away in the... I'm not going to hand any to Bashir, I'm not going to hand any to you, Arif. And then Mabub comes on, you all drop it. So what do you not do? So tell me exactly, what do you homeboys do? Really intrigued. So tell me, focus. So what do you guys do? What do you guys do? You shut the mustard down, what do you like start doing? Boogieing and dancing, what do you do like? Oh, yeah. I mean, what do you guys do? Tell us. We don't know. You know, tell the local community what you do with a 3,000 capacity empty masjid. What do you lot do? Because you failed to get money on Jummah. No one wants to give you guys money, man.
No one wants to give you.
You know, after I've told everyone, after I've exposed you homeboys that he's going to be spent on legal fees and thousands. And tell me, by the way, who is your donor? Who's your donor? I mean, you lot, I mean, if you lot were project managers in a firm somewhere, in some American high-flying software firm, you lot would get sacked. What results have you brought your donor? The person who's giving you money to take these brothers to court, to get them banned, to get them mustered in whatever, in his name maybe, or in your name, or to turn it into a nightclub, you know, to turn it into a private property. That guy ain't getting any results, man. That guy, that homeboy ain't getting any results, man. You lot have failed that homeboy big time. How do you not even show your face? I bet he whips you. He whips you one time. Get in my office now. Sorry. He must whip you, man. You've wasted that homeboy's money, man. Who is that homeboy? Who's this billionaire, like, you know, who is it? Jose Mourinho, Roman Abrahamovic. Who is funding you homeboys? Who's funding you homeboys? Where are you not getting the money from?
This billionaire, he ain't gonna cover 70k.
If he was a billionaire, he would have bought the mustard, mate, by now. He would have bought it. Probably got rid of you guys, man. You're an embarrassment, man. Didn't even get an injunction out against us, man. Honestly, really, man. What are you guys like, man? Watch this video. Police, Sergeant Talek, Sergeant Nash. Honestly, really. You know I've got a point. You know I've got a point. These homeboys went to, you know, if they're being funded, that guy's going to say, listen, I want some results, man. Yeah. Where's my revenue? Where's my dividends? Where's my end of the year profits? Where's the balance of payments, profit and loss account? You guys are on loss. Get some injunctions. Yeah, get some people banned. What have you not done?
I think if they're going for 2 years, I mean, they've been having money given to them for like 2 years now. So there's got
to
be some.
We don't know which homeboy is funding them, to be honest with you. We don't know which homeboy is funding them.
We don't need to. We're never going to know.
You know, they've rinsed that. Oh, we'll find out. When we get the mustard back, can you imagine going into the office and getting the accounts? Paper trails will exist unless you lot do like a JP Morgan and start shredding everything. Shred everything. Oops. Shred everything. Shred everything. You know, before you leave, man. Oh my God. And remember, it's non-incorporated. So you boys are going to be liable for any fees that are going to be picked up. Because when we come back into power, and remember, it happened in Harrow. You know, they had to do another court case to get the money back to be reimbursed against. Yeah. Apparently, I'm going to get a full story from one of the brothers. The story that took place in Harrow, that is similar, identical thing. The congregation eventually who the committee were a similar, identical scenario, who they were attempting to ban. It happened over in Harrow and they tried to ban him. Master Subhanallah, the congregation got power back with the help of the courts. This is what I've been told. And then they went after the people that done the cases, the false allegations, similar to our committee. Allegedly, because I don't have all the facts on me. And so they went after them, and they got the money back. They had to do another case altogether, spend money on that, but they got reimbursed. They got their legal costs.
How long did it take?
It took some time, but...
We've been friends for a long time.
You know, but listen, if Roman Abramovic is funding you guys, obviously you got Chelsea supporter, my man. Chairman is a Chelsea supporter, no less. My man Arif Sheikh is a Chelsea supporter. If he is funding you homeboys, you need to start coming up with some results, because your results have been really, really terrible, man.
Definitely.
Honestly, really, really, really terrible. Police can see that it's the Wembley Central Masjid issue. That's why they, you know, a 10-foot barge pole, that old expression, that cliche, touch everything with a 10-foot barge pole. You know, you had the other, you know, anyway, listen, look, the video's gone on for long enough. You know, start getting some results, start getting some people arrested as you normally would like to, but there's no one around to provide you the evidence, you know, so you can just, like I saw one Arif, what's his name again? I saw the... No, the other guy, man. Night. The Anayat filming in the dark, because there was no one on the other side of the gate. So what he's doing, he's filming the roof of the central hall, then he turns the camera. What are you doing? Chasing your own shadows, homeboy. What are you doing? Chasing your own shadows, man. Turn the lights on, and then you might be successful in getting your own shadow. At the very, very least, filming in the dark. Have you got the new, like, iPhone 12? Anyway, listen, look, over and out. is there anything else that we can add to this video besides just moaning and groaning and, you know, whatnot? You know, moaning and just pondering over these Zindiq type individuals that have control of our masjid. I
don't know.
Should we sign this video out? Yes. Assalamu alaikum.
Oh, don't do it. Assalamu alaikum.